J-Ray 501. So back in September, I sent the Fukushima U.S. aid transcript audio files September 10th to at least four people who I felt would be better suited to discuss this information. However, no one did. I even gave pages. Anyway, you know, no big deal. But now there are people that are going in here, and I would like to try to encourage other people to do the same. So what I'm going in on is the telephone conversations, the audio file, and there's a few things here that I wanted to go over. So sorry if I make you dizzy. Okay. So this is in regards to basically, this is the 16th of March 2011, and they had already had severe issues with reactor 4. Well, they thought about taking a helicopter to haul in sand or water. They just haven't tried it yet. I don't know what they're waiting for. Dave Skeen. Yes, right. Now, let me tell you, we were doing some possibly talking with PMP about how much dose rate you should have over that four spent fuels pools. And it's hundreds of thousands of rads right now, about 20 meters above the spent fuel pool. Okay, yeah, so dropping from a helicopter isn't an option. Isn't really an option. But what I would say is if you can get some data that tells you what the dose really is coming off that, what your source term is now, that will help you. And if you look back at Chernobyl, thank God they're, you know, looking back at this, one of the lessons they learned from that, from the helicopter pilot, I think they had 8 pilots that flew until they died. Basically, the cables that they had to drop the sand were too short, and so they got too much exposure. Okay, so that was sad. Now I want to go down to, let's see here. Okay. This is again about number 4. And they're talking about bringing in, you know, what they're going to need. Because at this point, the Japanese government was inept at what they were doing. They had holes in their hoses, and I mean, it was just really getting tough. So they're trying to help, but Tepco is not really wanting to work with them. Okay, so then they started having meetings with the ambassador. Okay, so they're trying to bring in as many people as they can. I'm ever more convinced that there's nothing more. There's major damage to that building, and I just have to stake my career on it. But I don't see that there's any structural integrity there at all. You know, there was steam last night at 5 o'clock when the helicopter went by, steam and smoke. Who knows? It might have been a fire inside the building. You just can't tell. That was Unit 4. Okay. Do we know what the status is? We're doing some MAC runs on a kind of worst case scenario to see what the West Coast impacts would be. Do we know the status of those results? In the meanwhile, while we're waiting for that, we wanted to let you know we heard from Chuck, Casto, and some of the information that we just received. Okay, so they want to do some of their... they want to get the report back from NAROC on the runs they were doing on the West Coast implications. Okay, I thought we were running our own independent runs. We can't do that beyond 50 miles. 50 miles, I think, is the limits of our tools. So they decided to run MAC codes of our own, independent from NARAC. Out of research? Okay, out of research. Yes, out of research. Okay, we'll check. Okay, so this is part of where the cover-up kind of starts. There's a lot of priorities. This might not be a priority on the list. That's fine. Okay. Sorry. Okay, let me ask the question. So we're responding to the ambassador's request at this point to get some calculations. Okay, let me ask the question. Isn't there an ALARA consideration here at some level? We calculate that if, in fact, the assumptions made relative to your 50-mile peg calculations come to pass, that you would get like 1 to 2 REM total effective dose equivalent out to 150 to 200 miles. And wouldn't it make sense, if we're talking now voluntary departure, wouldn't it make sense to recommend voluntary departure in the name of avoiding that level of population dose? Okay, ALARA stands for as low as reasonably achievable in regards to dose limits and exposure, minimizing radiation exposure. Okay. That you would get like 1 to 2 REM total effective dose equivalent out to 150 to 200 miles. Wow. So, 1 to 2 REMs. Okay, so 100 millirems per year is what the standard for ALARA is. Number of public on site, 100 millirems per year, whole body exposure. So they're talking about 1 to 2 REMs, which is 1,000 millirems. So even at 1 REM, 1,000 millirems is what? 100 times? 900 times? What the standard is, 100 millirems. So that's why this person is trying to push the fact that they need to consider the ALARA levels. Do you want my personal opinion? That's my personal view, and radiation is just one factor. Right, so, but we are charged with advising on radiation, or are you charged with advising, and that's in our protective action, to up to 50 miles, right? But why are we being so rigid in terms of doing the right thing? The right thing is an ALARA thing here, in addition to strict interpretation of PEG. Okay, so at this point, they're struggling to stay within the parameters of the restrictions. And yeah, so the question is, how much should the law play into all these decisions that they're having to make so that they can talk with the ambassador? Now, if we were asked to advise strictly on radiological grounds, you would or would not take into consideration ALARA? Yes, I would. But I keep coming back to, I think that if you're out beyond the 50-mile zone, there are other factors. That bear on this decision. Okay, so this is where it gets interesting, because they want to try to deal with the people, but now they've got other factors they've got to deal with. So, acknowledging that radioactive dose is just one of the many considerations. These are tough decisions. I'm not saying they're right, but some of the other things they have to think about are transportation, infrastructure, communications, all of these things that could just crush and ruin a country. So, it's just got to be an amazingly stressful situation that they, you know, have to deal with. Okay, so I just wanted to put that out. I can't imagine how these guys could have stayed up all night, slept on the floor, and they did what they had to do. I'm not going to sit here and criticize one way or another. I'm just reading to you what they did do. So I've got more, and as always, God bless.